Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. This is Sunil Kumar Jadhav. Here in this video we are going to see one important construction of standard 10 mathematics, that is to draw the tangent to the given circle. The question is, that is, this question is taken from exercise 11.2 NCERT textbook, that is question number 3. Draw a circle of radius 3 cm. Take two points P and Q on one side of its extended diameter, each at the distance of 7 cm from its center. Draw the tangent to the circle from these two points, that is P and Q. Means, first of all, we have to draw the circle with 3 cm radius, and then we have to take this two point P and Q on the extended diameter at the distance 7 cm from the center and both the either side. And then we have to draw the tangent to the circle from that particular point. Let us begin this. First of all, you can see that draw the circle of radius 3 cm. So first of all, we will draw the circle with the given radius. Let us measure it. That is this one. You can see it is 3 cm. It is 3 cm. I will draw the circle first of all with the given measure. Friends, be careful while you are drawing the any construction. The pencil should be run only once. So this is the circle with 3 cm radius. Take two points P and Q on the extended diameter. So first of all, I'll give the name of this point. Let me say the point is O. Now I will draw the diameter to it. You can see, we know that what is the definition of diameter. Diameter is a line segment which is having both the end point, that is lying on the circle, and it is passing through the center of the circle. Or in another way, we can define the diameter in such a way that it is the chord of the circle which is passing through the center of the circle. Now we have to take two point, that is point P and Q, both on the either side of this diameter, that is from 7 cm from its center. So this is the center point. I will extend the diameter first, or in that case I will directly take the measure that we want to take it at the 7 cm. So I will extend up to that much only. You can see this is 0. I will extend this diameter up to 7 cm. It is this 7 cm. You can see we have extended this diameter from the center up to 7 cm, and I'll give the name of this point. Let me say that is Q. At this side we'll take it P. Now you can see this is 7, so I will bring it the diameter up to 0, so that would be 7 cm. Or even you can keep the 0 here and you can draw it is one in the same thing. I will extend it. You can see it is 0 to 7 cm. Now I will give the name of this point. Let me give the point name, that is P. So we have taken two points, one P and another one is Q, on the extended diameter of the given circle. Now draw the tangent to the circle from these two points. That means we need to draw that tangent from point P as well as point Q. Now let us draw it. We know that for doing that, first of all, I will take the radius more than half for this OP. I will take the distance more than half to the measure of OP, and I will keep the point on this, and I will draw the arc in both the semiplane. By keeping same measure, I will keep the point on O, and then I will draw the arc which intersect to our previous arc at a particular point. So I will draw that line which is exactly passing through this two point, that is intersecting point of both the arc. So this is one. You can see So we can consider that this point, let me give the name of this point. This we have taken PO, I will write it M. So this M point is the midpoint to this line segment OP. Now we have to take the measure from P to M, or I can say from M to O, because both the point, both the distances would be similar. Why is it so? Because this M point is a midpoint. So I'll take this measure, that is up to O, or I can say I have taken the distance from P to M. It is the same thing. So I'll keep the point on M, and I will take MO, or I can say MP, as a radius. So I will take M as a center and MO as a radius, and then I will draw the circle. You can see. Now this circle that I have drawn by taking M as a center and MO as a radius, that intersect the given original circle with center O and radius 3 cm at two distinct points, this one and this one. Let me give the name of this point. Let me give this point name, that is point A, and this point is said to be point B. I'll draw it. This is, let me say, PB, and another ray I will draw it, that is PA. So both this will be the tangent from point P. So this is how we have drawn two tangent, that is PB and PA, to the given circle from point P. Similar thing we have to do it from point Q. For that also we have to follow the same step. For that, what do we do? First of all, I'll take the measure that is more than half to this OQ. So that I'll do it. You can see this is about more than half. Even if you don't worry, if it is less than half, then both the arcs will not intersecting. Means then you can again extend it. So need not to bother that either it is more than half or not. You can see both of these are intersecting each other. In the case if it is less than half, then I can show you that suppose it is less than half, then what would happen in that case? Here one arc must be there and another arc would be here, means both the arcs will not intersecting each other. So here this two intersecting point of the arcs, we got it. I will pass, or I will draw the line passing through this two intersecting points, that is this one. Wherever this line intersecting to this OQ at the point, let us give the name of that point, point N. And now again we have to follow the same step, that we need to take this distance, that is O to N, or I can say N to O, or N to Q. Both would be same because it's the midpoint. So this and this distance would be same. So I will take NO or NQ as a radius and N as a center, and I will draw the circle with this. You can see. So here both the circle are, means this circle intersecting to the original circle at this point as well as this specific point. Let us give name of this point. We have given here it is AB, so I'll give the name of this point, point C, and here I'll give the name of point, that is point D. And then I will draw, that is QC, one tangent, that is tangent QC from point Q, and another tangent that I will draw from point Q, that is QD. This one, how is it tangent? How do you know that this is a tangent? For that case, you know that, okay, if we draw this, say for example, I will draw this radius from point O to A, then that is perpendicular to this one. You can see perpendicular, we should measure it. That is 90. Exactly, you can see this is 90. So I can say that OA, I should write in the justification that this radius OA is perpendicular to this PA. Similar way, I can say OB is perpendicular to this one, that is this radius would be perpendicular to PB. In the similar way, from point Q we have drawn two tangents, so I can say OC, line segment OC is perpendicular to this QC. OC perpendicular to QC, and for this point it is O, so that is OC, exactly. And this OD, that is line segment OD, which is a radius, which is also perpendicular to this QD. Here also I'll write it ray. That means this OA is perpendicular to PA, as we saw. That is, this PA is a tangent to this circle from point P. Similar way, OB is perpendicular to PB, means this PB is the another tangent. Similar way, from point Q, we can see this is one of the tangent QC. It means OC is perpendicular to QC. And similar way, OD is perpendicular to QD. That is, OD is perpendicular to QD. So this is how we have drawn two tangent from each point, that is P and Q, to the given circle. That this point P and Q are at the distance of 7 cm from the center of the given circle. So this is how you can draw this construction. I hope it is very easy and you can understand it. If this construction would be asked in exam, you can easily write it. Thank you so much.